أيها النبي قل لأزواجك وبناتك ونساء المؤمنين يدنين عليهن من جلابيبهن ذلك أدنى أن يعرفن فلا يؤذين وكان الله غفورا رحيما.
الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. Special guest of honor, our guest speaker, Hajia Aisha, the Amira of Form One, the wife of the DGSS, my sisters and brothers all here today, I greet you with the greetings of the people of paradise. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. It is my honor and privilege to be here this afternoon or this morning and to be part of this auspicious occasion. This is a special day, a day where the women of Nigeria and the world over come together to talk, deliberate, educate, and enlighten on the importance and virtues of hijab. I want to thank, first and foremost, our speaker. She did very well and she presented her paper explicitly. And I think we'll go home with so many of the points and important matters she has raised in that paper. This is another time that we women come together to talk about the hijab. It's not that we do not know what the hijab is or what it means, and we are not saying that today is the only day we shall be talking of the hijab. The hijab, to me, is an act of worship. It's an act of ibadah. We Muslim women should first and foremost ask ourselves, why do we need the hijab? Why are we putting on the hijab? Most of us know, and for the benefit of those that still want to know, the hijab is a command by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's a command. We have no option about it. I have asked so many people when they ask me, why do you always wear the hijab? I used to ask them, do you know that we Muslims, we pray 5 times a day? They will say yes. Do you know that we have been commanded to fast? They will say yes. And I will mention some of the acts of ibadah that they know or they need to know. And I will tell them we were commanded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to practice those ibadahs. And the hijab was among them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah An-Nur, ayat 31, commanded us, the women. وَقُلِ الْمُؤْمِنَاتِ يُغْدِنَّ مِنْ أَبْصَارِهِنَّ. Up to the end of the ayah, it's a very long ayah, surah, yeah, ayah, where Allah even went to tell us, where should we have the hijab, where should we not have the hijab? Is it in front of our husbands, our sisters, our brothers, our uncles, our daughters? The daughters of our sisters, the daughters of our aunties, he went to explain to us all about this. And then in the second surah I want to mention, it's in Surah Al-Ahzab 59, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also commanded the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, where he said, Ya ayyuha an-nabiyyu, qulil azwajika wa banatika وَنِسَاءِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ يُدْنِنَّ عَلَيْهِنَّ مِنْ جَلَابِيبِهِنَّ ذَلِكَ أَدْنَى أَنْ يُعْرَفْنَ وَلَا يُؤْذَنَ وَكَانَ اللَّهُ غَفُورًا رَحِيمًا. In this ayah, Allah commanded the Prophet, O you prophets, command your wives, command your children, the female children you have, and command the believing women. Al-Mu'minat is that there's a difference between Al-Mu'minat and Al-Muslimat. All Mu'minas or Mu'minin are Muslims, but not all Muslims are Mu'minat. I think from the little education I have, you need to study more about this, and you'll find this out. If Allah, we go directly to say, not even all the Muslims women could put on the hijab, only the Mu'minas, then you know there's a special command. If you are wearing the hijab, it shows your high rate of iman. It shows your taqwa, the fear of Allah you have. And it shows that you want to comply and be identified as a Muslim woman. It is easy to say we are Muslims, but it's not easy to be identified as a Muslim, only if Allah gives you the strength, the iman, to show your face and stand up for Islam. It is not usually done, only with the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Muslims, we are supposed to be ambassadors of Islam. We represent Islam wherever we are. And if you believe in what Allah has commanded you to, you don't need anybody to tell you to please put on your hijab and be proud to show you are a Muslim. The guest speaker did say so many nice and educative things. Yes, sometimes the problem lies with us, the Muslims, the family members, or even the Muslims. You might be wearing the hijab and somebody will look at you as somebody who is trying to be extra. Well, so many people have so many names for we that wear the hijabs. And it's not easy, especially if you go to work, if you mingle with people that are not Muslims, it's quite difficult for you to feel comfortable where you are not wanted with the hijab on. But if you have the fear of Allah, you know you are not putting it on for anybody, you take your head high up and continue to wear your hijab, because it is your right. You have the right to put on your hijab. If anybody has the right to walk out naked and be hailed and snapped because they look beautiful, look in their nudity, then I see no reason why you should not look up and put your head high up with your hijab. You have the right to. She has said it in her speech. It is a fundamental human right. It is not a favor being done to us by allowing you to wear the hijab. So I hope, as we Muslims, we need to do a lot of work. We need to do a lot of enlightening. We enlighten people that are not Muslims or that want to know about Islam itself. If you can see what is happening in the international world today, I want to appraise those Muslims there. It is not easy, but they all stand up in unity to explain to those that are not Muslims what Islam is and what Islam represents. That is how we should be seen here today. We should unite. Wherever there is an issue, we should unite to enlighten the people without violence. We just need to enlighten. We need to dialogue. It's so simple. And I'm very proud with some of them in the international world. Immediately you explain to them, they explain what they understand, they accommodate, they tolerate, and they respect each other. That is how we should be seen. We need to tolerate each other. We need to respect each other's religion. Allah has created us differently, and he has said it. He has divided us into nations and tribes so that we may understand each other. I think the Muslims, we need to do a lot. We need to keep enlightening people. We need to show people the beauty of Islam. We need to show people and educate people what Islam stands for. You shouldn't be shy of being a Muslim. There will be a day at the hereafter when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam will be saying, my ummati, 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 ummati. He will be calling on the Muslims, saying to Allah, my people, my people, my people. If you do not represent Islam, how do you expect to come up and say, oh, the Prophet, here I am? When you were never an ambassador of Islam, you do not represent Islam. You were not identified with your hijab. How do you become his ummah, his ummah, his ummah? Please, women, we should, you know, take a good example of the people that were not even Muslims that used to wear the hijab. Islam was not the first religion to, you know, bring about the issue of hijab and to enforce hijab on so many people. I used to tell people, we have seen the statue of the mother of Isa alayhi salam. She has always been covered. I have never seen her picture or her statue where she has her hair flowing on her back and what have you. She is the mother of Jesus, Isa alayhi salam. She is always covered. So I think we should even say it. We do not introduce the hijab. Before the coming of Islam, other religions existed. And we were meant to respect those religions, especially their prophets. We are supposed to believe in all the prophets that were sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you can see, Islam is just trying to comply, to emphasize, to educate what has been laid by so many religions before us. I hope Allah will make it easy for us to comprehend and to be good ambassadors of Islam wherever we find ourselves. I would like to make this suggestion to the guest speaker. It would be very good if all your papers, you can share your papers to our viewers here and even those that were not able to make it. I think it will go a long way in educating and helping them understand the virtues of putting on the hijab. And as from today, hash as stand for hijab, is that what your topic is? I think we should carry it on as our banner, as it is being carried all over in the world today. Before I end my speech, I want to thank most sincerely the organizers of this day, special day. We really appreciate you, and we pray to Almighty Allah to continue to give you the wisdom, the strength, and the ability to carry on such good works, inshallah. From this short speech of mine, I want to thank you also for inviting me and to be part of this special occasion. It wouldn't have come at a better time where women, the Muslims, and everyone around the world need to explain and to stand up for hijab. Thank you. Subhanaka Allahumma wa bihamdika. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Assalamu alaikum.
الحمد لله رب العالمين.